Welcome to the Pond Plant Girl Show. I'm your host, Gail Gates, and today we're going to be talking about potting your plants indoor and outdoors. So stay with me. First of all, let's talk about the Hungry Garden news. The Hungry Garden has moved on to greater and better things and has let the Visalia Rescue Mission take it on themselves. So that is a success story. So I started the Hungry Garden at the Visalia Rescue Mission in Visalia. And now they're operating it's almost 3 acres on their own. So right now we're looking for a new Hungry Garden. We have a lot of different choices, and one of which might be the Quakers property in Farmersville, I believe. In Farmersville, and that's just a little right next to Visalia, and they have 25 acres that they're thinking of farming and feeding the hungry. So word's catching on. So some things that you can do if you're interested in feeding the hungry, it's not too difficult. A lot of us have extra food, whether it's extra zucchini or extra fruit from the trees or extra anything from your garden that you don't know what to do with. And there's a lot of needy families out there. So instead of just, you know, handing it out to friends who don't want it and let it rot, there are people like me. No, just kidding. There are people out there that actually really need some good and healthy foods. A lot of times when people think about giving to the hungry, they give canned foods, which are full of preservatives and salts and everything like that. And a lot of times it's food that they don't want that they give to the poor. And I was there once and it was kind of miserable. Anyway, if you have extra produce or anything like that you would like to give to the hungry, contact your local food bank and find out where you can take your produce to. Or any local churches or clubs can also help you with that. Some exciting news! Okay, I've hooked up with the Quakers, a nice bunch of people, very friendly, very warm. And they have a radio show in Visalia. They have invited me to do the Pond Plant Girl on the radio. So if you are interested in being one of my guests on the Pond Plant Girl show, radio time, don't have a name for it yet. But anyway, if you're interested in being a guest, please send me an email to gail@pondplantgirl.com. Let's talk about potting your plants. A big misperception is that when you pot your plants or when you transfer plants to a new pot is to break up the roots. That is a big no-no. Okay, here I've got a giant artichoke plant and it's getting big, and I have even bigger ones too. I have all sizes, and this guy I need to repot because I put him in some pretty heavy soil. And I want to put them in some light and fluffy soil so it won't cost me so much to ship them out to you. And I've got all kinds of artichokes. I've got the giants make really, really tasty artichokes. Most people are familiar with the green globes that are in the grocery store. And so this is the tasty secret right here, the giant artichoke. Anyway, if you want to repot your plant, whether it's a house plant or you get one from the nursery or from me, you want to hang on to it right here. And I'm making a mess. Oh. And notice it doesn't want to come out. And I'm dirty. So it's not coming out. You can squeeze around like so to loosen it up. Gently tap, and this guy doesn't want to come out. And if that doesn't work, holy cow, it's really stuck. If that doesn't work, I could probably get it out if maybe I worked on the edges some more. Or a lot of times when I have ones that are really stubborn like this, I'll take a pair of scissors or something sharp and cut down the pot and get it out. But the last thing you want to do is like pounding it and jerking it around and making a mess like I just did on myself. So anyway, I want to show you one with roots all over the place. Let's find another one. Hello, my pretties. Here's a violetta. All right, I just planted it, and this one I want to transplant also, so it's easier to ship out to you. Violetta artichokes are really pretty because they not only make that pretty, pretty flower, like you see on all the artichokes, which are actually a thistle, for your information. Okay, let's give this a try. Ah, this one works. The violettas, they grow purple artichokes instead of just green. Okay, notice the roots are packed around. Now, if I was going to plant this in the ground, I would dig a hole, and I would put, for artichokes especially, I would put manure at the bottom, some cured manure, and some 10-10-10 fertilizer or Osmocote at the bottom, not up against the roots. So you got your hole, you put down your fertilizer and your manure at the bottom, put some soil over that so it doesn't touch the roots. This will draw the energy down and make your plant even more healthy. But another neato secret is bananas. According to the FarmersAlmanac.com, banana peels aren't just for mosquito bites anymore. They are used for soil enrichment. Adding banana peels to the soil helps tomato and green pepper plants to thrive. And so you chop up your peels and place several in the hole before planting your seedlings, and then you'll have some strong plants popping up. You can give your banana peels a boost by mixing it with water and allowing it to ferment. Here's a good one. Liquid plant fertilizer. Stick your banana peel in a blender. In a blender, one part banana peels along with three parts of water and puree. Very good for your plants. So save those banana peels and stick them in the ground. I'd like to say hello to my new garden friend, Patrick Whalen from Visalia. Hi, Patrick. I'm glad that we're friends. Hey, everyone. Thanks for coming by. This is Gail Gates. And you keep on being you, and I'll see you next time. Good girl.